how to kickflip today. Before you start trying kickflips, you want to be at the very least just comfortable riding around on the board and have a nice solid leveled out ollie. Now, having some other tricks will definitely help out, especially if one of those tricks is heel flips, but most people learn kickflips before heel flips, so it's not that big a deal if you don't. Now, before you do anything, take some paint or a rock and make a mark about where the nose starts. This is going to show you exactly where your foot needs to go off the board to make the board flip. Now for the foot position. I like to have my front foot a little bit down from the front bolts and add a little bit of an angle with my pinky toe knuckle at the edge of the board. Now for my back foot, it's on the edge of the tail, a little bit closer to the heel side pocket to try to help balance out the board. Now this is just my foot position. Everybody has their own, so you're probably gonna have to play around with it for a while until you figure out exactly what you need. But a general rule of thumb, the more of your foot you have on the board, the slower the board's gonna spin, and the less of your foot, the faster you can get it to spin. Now let's see how the kickflip works. Now with your feet in the kickflip position, bend down just like you would for a regular ollie, but make sure to keep your board level and not turn like this so it'll stay under you. And then on the way back up, pop your board straight down and then start sliding your front foot up towards that mark you made earlier. Now when you get there, retract your ankle muscles and suck your legs up to allow the board to spin under you until you see the grip tape, and then place your feet gently down on it and roll away. Now it may sound easy, but let's break it down so we can learn it. Now the first thing you're going to want to do is have your feet in the kickflip position and just tap your tail like you did with ollies to get used to your feet being like that. Now something that helped me out a lot was setting timers and working on each practice step for a certain amount of time and only focusing on that. Once you're ready to move on, put all your weight on your tail and slide your front foot up towards that mark, and then retract your ankle muscles to practice flicking. Now when you're doing this, make sure your foot goes out to the side like a ninja kick and not down, because if your front foot gets lower than the board, it's going to be super hard to get it back on top so you can land. Something you can do to make sure you don't flick down is record yourself so you can see exactly what your front foot is doing. Now you're ready to combine both practice tips, so pop your board, slide your front foot up, flick, and make sure your foot goes out to the side. Now this might sound a little bit weird, but try to do a kickflip but only land with your front foot. This is going to help you figure out how to flip the board as well as build up some confidence. Now when you're ready to try a kickflip for real, one of the biggest problems you'll likely run into is having the fear of the board flipping under you. So something you can do is toss your board into the grass and try to do a half a kickflip, focusing on sucking up your legs into your chest and landing with both feet on the bottom of the board before you go all the way. Now another thing you can do is take the wheels and trucks off and do a couple of ollies before trying some half flips before going through the whole flip. The kickflip is a hard trick, and the biggest thing you want to avoid is just rushing through all the practice steps, because then you're setting yourself up for failure. So if you slow down and really master each step, you're going to actually get the trick a lot faster and easier. And now you're ready to try some kickflips. So if you have any questions, problems, concerns, or anything else, leave a comment down below and I'll try my best to help you out. Have fun. Sayonara. Love you.